part of it. But the whole concept, Lai Mohammed, for me, was a very effective spokesperson for the APC. I don't think he's effective as a minister of information.
Okay, but the figures have not been disputed by...
I don't think you are right. I disagree with you. Lai Mohammed is effective as an information minister. He's very effective. And you see, what he has done now, if he didn't react to that challenge, how will you have reacted?
So, because of the challenge?
No, a challenge that questions the credibility of the government in which is the information minister.
Then let the EFCC release the issue, release the figure.
That has come to the government?
The EFCC is part of the government.
Is that the only challenge that has come to the government?
You see, exactly. Like I said before, at the beginning of this discourse, I believe government should have gone a step further by arraigning these suspects in court. I also believe that names should not be maligned without proper procedure. I've said that. But I'm saying that it will be responsible of an information minister who has facts. And his government frontally is being challenged. That government is just banding figures. For such an information minister to keep quiet. What he has done is to speedily respond based on facts. And he has put facts in the national space. Let those facts be disputed.
Mr. Shisu, I'll take you again to that court order.
Yes.
Which is there. Uh-huh. And which the government agreed to respond and they agreed to publish. So if the government is challenged by the PDP, say, you've gone ahead and said, so publish the names, let's see. Why didn't they just go ahead to publish that list that the court said they should publish, the list of looters, say how much was recovered from there, and in what circumstance these monies were recovered?
That is a court order.
So, and the government agreed to obey that court order. Okay. But what has been published here does not look like what the court asked for.
Okay, so part of our resolution from this gathering is to insist that the full
list...
is to insist on complying with court order. Not just that court order. All court orders. Because we're in a democracy.
Agreeing that the government has a problem with obeying court orders?
No, I'm saying that... Please don't put me in a tight spot. Okay. What I've said is that in some cases, court orders have been made without government obeying. And you know that is in the public space. I disagree with that kind of option. I also disagree with a media trial. I believe persons who have cases to answer should be made to go through.
What is a media trial?
This is a media trial.
For instance, there's no way you can look at it, like he said, which I partly agree. Politicians are also playing politics. They are campaigning. But I'm saying that this issue is beyond the political elite. It's a very serious matter. You don't campaign with such issues.
You think this is a media trial?
In some way, when you publish names of people as having looted,
as they say, it's verified
without
facts.
Without going through the process of the rule of law. I frown that.
So what do we do with this list? Do we discard this list?
My honest view is that
My view is this.
Nigerians should maintain an open mind, and insist. That due process and the rule of law should be followed by the persons whose names have been mentioned should be brought before courts of competent
judicial. Do you think this is an authentic list?
This list.
Do you think it's authentic?
Well, I have no reason to doubt the authenticity of this list.
What I'm querying
is the procedure. You understand me? Because I'm a rule of law.
It's understandable. Yes,
I'm trained
from that legal perspective.
And I don't want reputations are involved here.
We'll get your point.
I believe that government should go ahead.
We're going to wrap up soon, but go ahead.
This list has been put out by government. The onus is on government to prove their guilt.
Yes.
Therefore, if I were the information minister, for this press conference to hold, the chairman of EFCC will be on my right side, his director of operations will be on my left side, and they will be the ones to release these names as updates on as part of their investigation.
Now, if the FCC did that, I wanted to react to that.
Yes.
You will say the FCC is engaging in media trial.
No, but they will say that.
You say the FCC is engaging in media trial. I think what we should
Can we look at something else?
No, let me just say this. This point must be made that these issues are already in court. We are prosecuting
some
them.
Of them.
Some of them diligently. These are the new ones we are taking to court. There are some people here who have merely been arrested, have written statements, and have gone home. There are many of them there. They have been arrested or detained first day, come to report second day, by the third day.
Would it be fair to say they've gone home? Because he's speaking about the process. So the process may
the
be
the process up. Is questionable.
Do you think that this is credible? Okay.
Is
the credibility of this list on the question when you look at a first list that was released that had just PDP names on it, and then we had a second list that had people from just about both parties and even in the economy?
I won't say both parties. What list we have here are PDP people and former army commanders and generals or what have you.
So that means it's not yet complete?
Well, I'm not privy to that information. I don't know if there are 300 and government.
Well, what I want to say is that the issue of whether somebody is prosecuted or not should not depend on the political platform he belongs to. The issue is,
but is that the case here?
If a crime has been committed,
more or less.
And I want to urge the government, everybody who has committed an offense should be brought to book. I don't believe that you should be excluded on account of the fact that because you belong to the ruling party or you belong to the PDP.
But is that the case here?
Well, the list here contains mainly those names of people who serve in the PDP previous administration. We need to make it balanced. But above all, my own submission here will be that let the courts do their job. Nigerians should learn how to reinvest faith in the judiciary.
Okay, because those who were referring to that court judgment think that if they had said we're referring in obedience to the court judgment, they are suggesting that you may have seen much more names which cut across board. So would that suffice for you if that were
possible? I believe reference to that court judgment or no reference to that court judgment is immaterial.
Okay, so
that judgment,
I think we agree here.
That judgment exists
to be fought
and it was a complex.
Let's redefine that. Names are here whose cases have been in court for 3 years. Here. For 3 years. It's still ongoing. They should not have been here. They should not have been here.
I agree because I
know now that the next time any matter comes up in court, the first thing will be for a lawyer to get up to say, my lord, I don't know what we are doing in your court. The government has already pronounced me a looter.
But the government is not the court.
No, but I mean, I'm saying if government took...
But that can equally be addressed in court.
There's a funny thing people used to say those days. They say, when you catch a thief, take him to the court, not to the criminal.
All right, we have to anchor at that point. At least we all agree that corruption needs to be fought.
But in accordance with the rule of law.
Processes in accordance with the rule of law.
Transparent process.
All right, Mr. Idego Abo and Mr. Wahabzi, gentlemen, thank you for coming on this morning. And happy Easter again to you all.
Thank you.
And that's the segment this minute. We'll be back. We still have some more to go. Don't go away.